Greetings and welcome to Soft Hints. In this video I want to share with you how to uninstall a Python module which was installed with pip and using a virtual environment. I will share with you what are the differences between using and not using virtual environment, what is going to change if you add user to pip install module, and finally some useful commands for pip. We are going to use Linux Mint as operating system, but the same apply in some way in Windows and macOS, Python 3.6 and pip 9. Before to start with all this, I wanted to share a funny joke about modern education. And as you can see, you need to swallow book by book in order to become a great student. And do you think this is the case for programming, that you need to swallow language by language and script by script in order to become a great programmer? Please do share your comments in the comment section below. My personal opinion is that this is not the case and you need to be really clever and smart and to practice a lot and filter the information that enter your head, but this is my personal opinion. I will wait for your. So let's go back on our example. Here you can see we are using PyCharm. I will activate terminal of PyCharm. You can see I have virtual environment already activated for me by PyCharm, which means that using a Python interpreter, which is virtual environment from PyCharm, this is going to activate the virtual environment. And installing a module in this virtual environment is going to add this module only in this virtual environment, which is the case for this virtual environment. You can see it here, but let's run this command and check the example. We have a requirement already satisfied because this module is already installed. You can see where it is installed, and the installation folder is under module, under the virtual environment, folder lib, Python 3.6 or the version that you are using, and site packages. Now let's uninstall this module and see what is going to happen. We are asked if we want to remove all these files. Yes, we want to remove them. And finally, successfully, this module is uninstalled and we don't have this folder anymore here. Let's install it again and see what is going to happen. Now it's installed. Here we have the folder. We have some Python files inside. And you can see that module is installed only in the virtual environment and not on the system or your home folder. The difference is that if you are not activating your virtual environment by this command in Linux or by using some other ways in Windows or PyCharm, and you are installing your module in your system, then this is the default folder which is going to be used for this installation. On the other hand, if you add user to this command, this is going to be the folder which is used for this module, and uninstalling them you need to remove the folder from these parent folders. You can change the version for your Python as you wish. For example, if you're using Windows, you may need to add the full command for pip in order to activate the right pip, and the same is for uninstall. I can show you in Linux what does this mean. We have our virtual environment, then we have a folder bin, inside we have pip. So I need to get this command here. You can do the same in Windows and then write it like this and add install or uninstall and name of a module. So this is how you're going to do it in Windows or in other environment if you need to do it, but I prefer to activate this environment by using source bin activate. You may want to see what packages do you have already installed in your virtual environment. This can be done with pip freeze. And now we can see the list of our installed packages. You can see do you have pip, because you can lack of pip. Now we can see that I have pip, which is installed in this folder. Let's deactivate this virtual environment by this command deactivate, and let's see if I have pip. No, I don't have pip, so I need to install. You can install it with this command on your operating system, but I don't recommend this to you. I recommend you to use virtual environment. I will share also how to use virtual environments in Python in the description below. So if you have any questions or suggestions or problems, please do share them also with your opinion about becoming a great programmer. I will wait for them. Thank you for watching and see you next time.